morning, and welcome to the Church of St. Patrick. Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Advent. Our second collection is the annual retired religious collection. This is to help make life a little easier in retirement for the many religious who served our diocese so faithfully over the years. Kindly make sure all cell phones are turned off before we begin our liturgy. On Gaudete Sunday, we rejoice with all the earth in anticipation and preparation for Jesus' birth and the coming of his kingdom. We, like John the Baptist, are blessed and included in the kingdom of heaven, not because of what we do, but what Jesus does for us. We remember at this Mass Faith Curran, our presider is Father Barnabas. Our gathering hymn is hymn number 349 on Jordan's Bank, hymn number 349. Please stand and join us.
God's nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing through our Lord Jesus Christ, our Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will exult. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers and rejoice with joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them, and in the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord, the splendor of our God. Strengthen the hands that are feeble, make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag, then the tongue of the mute will sing. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness. Sorrow and mourning will flee. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
See how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You too must be patient. Make your hearts firm, because the coming of the Lord is at hand. Do not complain, brothers and sisters, about one another, that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing before the gates. Take as an example of hardship and patience, brothers and sisters, the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Advent, the Sunday that is called the Rejoicing Sunday, Gaudete Sunday, that has its foundation of the theme of this Sunday from the first reading, whereby Isaiah tells us that all will be okay, things will be renewed, life will be good, if we can use the secular language of today. Things will be great, things will look good. And so he says, rejoice, be happy. That's what takes us into this third week of Advent, knowing that already the Church has given us 2 weeks to prepare, and now as we enter into the third week, we enter into this third week with this theme, rejoice. For what has been said will now be fulfilled. Things will be made new. Life will get better. Things will be okay, Isaiah says. And so then, if that is the case, Jesus, in the gospel reading, he asked us a question. When you went out to the desert, whom were you looking for? Whom were you looking for? That question still is relevant to us today. We are here this morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Whom are you looking for? I'm sure each one of us has the answer to that question. Whom are you looking for? And he says, there's someone greater than even John the Baptist. And who is that? It's Christ himself. He is greater than he. And so, that's the one we are looking for. That's why we are here. And he says, I am in your midst. Now, since he's in our midst, do we recognize his presence? Do we realize he's among us? That's the kind of a question that John the Baptist then posed. When he was still in prison, he heard about all that Jesus was doing. And since he couldn't go by himself because he was already in prison, he sends his disciples, please go and find out, is he the one I'm talking about? Why did John ask that question? There's something that John was quite not understanding. Because in his thinking at this particular juncture, he was looking for Messiah, Jesus, that would come and be so tough, to use the language of today, on the sinners. Someone is coming to judge and throw away those who are considered unwanted, the sinners, get them off the road and punish them severely. And on the contrary, here comes Jesus, whom he had said he prepared the way for his coming, and he has sitting and has a meal with the sinners. He has gone out to meet the people. He's sitting down with the marginalized, the poor, the crippled, the blind, the lame, the sick. And John is just wanting to confirm, is he the one I spoke about? And that's why then Jesus says to his disciples, the disciples of John, when you go back to visit him in prison, please tell him what you have seen and you have heard. The blind people can now see. The sick are cured. The hungry are fed. And the dead are raised alive. Just if I'm telling him what you have seen and heard, that is what about Christ. And since then we are his disciples, he is asking us today to do what our Savior did among us and continues to do. And what is it? To cure the sick among us. To feed the hungry among us. To visit the sick. To bring comfort and happiness to those who are marginalized. To clothe those who are naked, to feed the hungry, That's the way we can let the world know that Christ is among us. It's not so much about the solemn liturgies we can have. There may be a long, nice procession we can have in the church. It's more about giving a witness to what we believe that our Lord did and continues to do among us. That's the way we can recognize that He is in our midst, or else we may run into the same error of John the Baptist of asking, is Jesus here? Is He among us? And He says, yes, He is. Do you see Him? Yes, I do. See what is happening among His own followers. My dear brothers and sisters, we have no reason not to rejoice, because He is among us, He says. We just have to find out to make sure we recognize His presence. Again, the simple answers He gives in the Gospel today, go and tell John what you have heard and what you have seen. We have seen all this taking place in our own lives, in our own communities, in our own country. Sick people are getting cured. The hungry are fed. We are reaching out to help those who are in need. This is what we, the disciples of the Lord, are called to do. In the meantime, we are told to wait for His coming, and especially for His glorious coming. So in the context of waiting, then what must we do? Second reading, St. James answers that question. He says, brothers and sisters, be patient. Be patient, just as a farmer who goes out to plant corn, or maybe plant potato, or anything, or maybe even flowers. You don't plant a flower on Monday and get the fruit on Tuesday. You have got to wait. What does that entail? A farmer waits patiently until when is the time to harvest. That's a very practical, simple example that James uses in the second reading, which we can all relate. Patience. He says, wait patiently with hope and faith that all that has been said will come true. We are living in this world of today, whereby a little bit of a rush is like the order of the day. How many of us, dear brothers and sisters, you are simply driving, you know, you are on the road. You want to get from point A to point B, and all of a sudden, someone ahead of you is driving a little bit below the speed limit. What comes as a normal, natural reaction is, please, speed up. What to do with the fact? You are too slow. Well, it happens. Or you are driving and you run into a truck, a teen-wheeler's truck. And you can just say, instead of 65 miles per hour, whoever's driving is sort of 50 miles. What is the normal natural reaction? You are looking for the way either to, you know, go over the truck, or maybe in your mind you are wondering, what's going on here? And the good thing is, when you run the red light and takes about 2 minutes before the turns green, sometimes you can be a little bit impatient. As soon as it turns green, see how we go so fast. It's the world you are living today. Sometimes we wish the day could have at least 25 hours, not necessarily 24. Because at the end of the day, we haven't finished what we wanted to do. But the day is gone, 24 hours are over, just another day. This is the world you are living in, live along the technology. But today, James tells us it doesn't work like that with the things pertaining to God. And sometimes it does even affect our own spiritual life, our own prayer life. When we pray today, and we need an answer by now, 2 hours later, I need God to answer my prayers. It's like touching a little part in the computer and all of a sudden get an answer. Doesn't work like that. God takes his time. And so he says, brothers and sisters, be patient. It's going to happen. It has been said and is going to take place. So let us continue to rejoice, for what has been said will be fulfilled. And prepare, continue to prepare ourselves as we prepare for his coming, that he may find us ready. Let us continue to pray for one another. Support each other in this Christian journey, dear brothers and sisters. We need each other in this community of prayer. Uplift one another. Again, as Jesus says, reach out to those who are in need, to the sick people, to the elderly, to the marginalized, to the homeless, the hungry. Let them know that Christ is in our midst. Let them realize that what has been said about the good news being preached to the poor, let them hear those good news from us. We are the disciples of the Lord. And so then, whom have you come to see? I believe in the one God. God's word tells us to patiently await all the good things that the Savior brings. With the confidence, let us now make our needs and the needs of all throughout the world known to him.
During the season of Advent, Christ will form Francis, our Pope, all bishops, priests, and deacons, and every church leader into prophets and messengers to prepare his way. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That world leaders everywhere will prepare the way for the coming of the Lord by fostering harmony, authentic dialogue, and sincere concern for their people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And as we continue our Advent journey, the Holy Spirit will bring our faith community to a renewed awareness of God's presence in our lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That through the intercession of Our Lady of Guadalupe, patroness of the unborn, couples will experience the joy that comes with every new life, and that in joy will find strength to overcome the difficulties they may face. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the sick, those who suffer from fear and anxiety, and those who have asked us to pray for them, will experience God's peace and be comforted by his healing presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That all who have died in the light of faith, those who have died unremembered and unmourned, and Bernadine, Sister Mary Doris Burkhoff, James Stumman, Kathy Holman, and Charles Kolinkowski, may they experience the renewed life by the coming of the newborn Savior. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That Faith Curran, whom we remember at this Mass, will always share in the eternal banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And for those petitions we hold in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
Father, we hear your call to repentance and rejoice that our salvation is near. Make our hearts and your world ready for the coming of Christ your Son, for he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Please join in singing our preparation hymn number 352, O Come, Divine Messiah, hymn number 352.
Thank you.
Let us not ask the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is for the right and just our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere we give the thanks. By the Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the oracles of the prophet who are told in him, the Father and Mother will for him from the mouth of the Holy Ghost telling. John the Baptist, the sign of his coming, and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that sovereignty will rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that you may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and the archangels, with the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and the powers of the heaven, we sing the hymn of their glory, as without end we are blessed. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and again in advance he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of you."
Mystery of pain.
celebrates the memorial of the saving and passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the blessing of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by his death, you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that you will be nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and be filled with the Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that you may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and the glorious martyrs, and with the saint Patrick, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in the presence of the life and fairy hair. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your deliverance church in the world. With your servant, Pope Francis, our friend, our bishop, the all of the bishops and all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your honor. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, prepare us for the Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give God an image to your kingdom. There we hope that you forget by the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world, for that is good.
With your spirit.
Let us pray together. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are the souls of the supper of the Lamb.
Our communion hymn is number 345, O Come Emmanuel, hymn number 345.
Thank you.
Multiply your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A couple brief announcements for our parish family. Young adults in our parish are welcome to an evening of fellowship, libations, and reflections, and living in what it means to live the Catholic faith on December 15th, that's this Thursday, from 7 to 9 o'clock at the Crimson House. The event is free to attend, just pay for your choice of refreshments. Religious calendars are available in the back of the church today. They are free. Many thanks to Schlitzer Allen U Funeral Home for being our calendar sponsor. Next Sunday, the fourth Sunday of Advent, is the last day we'll be collecting for the Giving Tree for Catholic Charities in the back of church and for the hat and mittens for local children in need. Please bring your items next Sunday. Children can pick up their shoes that they left for St. Nicholas in the back of the church.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth to the Mass is held.
Thanks be to God.
Send you my body and my soul.
Defend us
from harm. Be our protection against the wickedness of the snare of the devil. May God the living within me humbly pray. And to thou, for his blood and the cross, by the power of God, pass on the blessed spirit, and all the evil spirits.
Please join in singing our recessional hymn number 361, People Look East, hymn number 361.